Hi guys, so I'm going to school now, so this is my house, and the weather is so dagom, and I will say to you that the summary of the Count of Monte Cristo. The Count of Monte Cristo by Alexandre Dumas is a classic story of an innocent man that wrongly liberated in prison and seeking for revenge for those people who betrayed him. The young sailor Edmond Dantès is a guileless and honest man whose peaceful life and plans to marry his woman in life, Mercedes, and a shattered when his best friend Fernand betrayed him. And also, his best friend was very jealous of him. Set up to be unlawfully and sentenced to the infamous island prison of Jetty Teif, Edmond is trapped in a nightmare for 13 years. Wow, 13 years? I cannot survive on that. In prison. Haunted by baffling course his life has taken over time. Everything he delivered about right and wrong is abandoned and replaced by all-consuming thoughts of vengeance against those who betrayed him. He almost lost faith of God, but someone helped him, and this is the priest. The priest, or his teacher, teach him all of the learnings that he must learn. And the priest taught him how to write, read, and also fencing. Dantès plots and succeeds in his mission to escape from prison, whereupon he transforms himself into the mysterious and wealthy Monte Cristo. With cunning ruthlessness, he cleverly institutes himself into the French nobility and systematically destroys the man who manipulated him and enslaved him. And these are the men who, the Villafuerte, Fernand, and his fellow dung lives. So guys, I'll go to the school because I am very, very late, and it's already 1 and it's already 8 a.m. in the morning. So guys, bye bye, stay still.
A few moments later.
I've been up all night, no sleep, cause I feel I'm always dreaming all night, no sleep.
Already 1:09 a.m. in the afternoon. So now let's talk about the characters. Edmond Dantès is a very noble man who was very innocent and was accused of murder and getting jealous of his best friend Fernand. For me, I describe Edmond Dantès as justice. Why? Because he seeks justice for those who betrayed him, and that who betrayed him. That's why he was in prison. The priest was described as the new life or the faith, because he teaches. Everything about life, how to write and read books of psychology, philosophies, and fencing. And also, I forgot, I'm so sorry, the ocean. The ocean describes like the rebirth of tactics, because
when Dantes escaped
from the Chateauneuf, he promised himself to seek revenge for those who betrayed him,
for those who accused him. That's why he promised himself that he will seek revenge for those people who betrayed him. And after that, he found a treasure and became very rich. And now, he became the account of the Monte-Cristo.
So here,
in the account of Monte-Cristo, so let's talk about Mercedes.
The love of Dantes, or the Count of Monte-Cristo. Yes. So, Mercedes was the only woman that loved by Dantes.
But when Dantes was in prison because of treason, they were getting married in that time. Wow, getting married in that time. Yeah,
and then
I thought that
this for me, I know what she felt. Like, she was very sad because of what happened to Dantes. But she believed that Dantes will return from prison.
They stay at home. When Dantes was in prison,
Mercedes thought that Dante was dead. So she doesn't have a choice to marry Fernand, who's the best friend of Dantes.
And the reason why she married Fernand, because
she needs to use Fernand for raising her child,
who was Clark Kent, the Superman, yeah, you know, Superman thing. And then
after that, when she realized that the Count of Monte Cristo was Edmund, she had mixed emotions, like very happy, sad.
In this story, women are like a women here use men to get their interest,
or use men to get what they need.
2 hours later.
In a town full of fancy cars and crowded bars and supermodels, looks exactly the way it did inside my head when I dreamed about it. All the things I could live without, I need them now, cause they're all around me. Only thing that I can't afford is to lose myself trying to be somebody. You should've known better than to.
This movie is a very good example of Marxism. Because poor and rich, strong and weak, like Edmond and Fernand. Edmond Dantes is very poor, and he can't write and read, but while Fernand Fernand is very rich and can write and read. So, and also he can fencing. That's why Fernand used his power to accuse Edmund to be in jail so that he can get Mercedes. So that's why poor people here in the story is very
what to call this, very sorry, escape. But after he escaped in prison, after he escaped prison, he find a treasure. Edmund find a treasure and became very rich. And he can continue the plans that he made to seek revenge for those people who betrayed him, especially for Nun. And when Edmund became rich, Fernand became poor because he always keep playing in the casino. The Cat of Monte Cristo was themed by vengeance and forgiveness. Vengeance, because when Edmund Santes seek revenge to Villefort, Danglars, and Fernand for putting him in prison. That's why he became the Count of the Monte Cristo to continue his plans. And forgiveness, because at the end, he asked forgiveness to himself and to God because he do bad things because of his anger. I've learned a lot about this story. Like, we must have good faith to God, because only God can help us, and only God can give us justice. In the story, I've learned that we must not lose faith to Him, and also we must not let our anger conquer us, because maybe we can do bad things like Edmund, and also we must be forgiving to others, because I know God will forgive us no matter what, and also God will guide us everywhere we go. So guys, this is the end of my vlog, so please appreciate this as a sign of your gratitude. It's like joke lang. And Jerbel, hi Jerbel, and thank you for everything that you taught to us. And sorry for the wrong grammars. And bye guys, I'm going to sleep now.
A few moments later.
I forgot guys, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and please help me and please like my video also, and thank you for liking. Bye bye.